can hear me, please put it in the comment section that you can hear me. Please, if you can hear me, put it in the comment section. Guys, can you hear me? Good morning. Hope you guys can hear me. Good morning, guys. Okay, so Faith said yes. Sawingo said yes, morning. Okay, I guess it's time to start the class then. So good morning, guys. This is Ola and Diakola Daniels, and this is another episode of Diakola Talks Law, and I will be talking about company law. I'll be talking about good morning, Faith. I'll be talking about partnership. Yes, I'll be talking about partnership. I'm sorry, I forgot. So yes, the questions we are going to be asking is, do you need to register a partnership company? One question. Second question is, do you need to register the business name of a partnership? Third question, does the partnership have a separate legal entity from the owners, and all of that, you know. But if this is your first time of coming to my channel, please make sure that you click the subscribe button, and also make sure you click the notification bell, so that anytime I have live sessions like this, or anytime I have other things, video to release, you are going to be one of the first set of people that will actually view those videos. So, moving into the class now. We are talking about partnership. I mean, we are asking, like the BC I sent, if you are on my WhatsApp contact list, I sent the BC. And I said we had four people that wanted to join partnership or have a partnership. And that is Taye, Kehinde, Idowu, and Alaba. And then the name of their partnership firm is Taki. I got the Taki from Taye, Kehinde, Idowu, and Alaba. That's like T-A-K-I. So Taki Legal Practitioners. Now, Taki Legal Practitioners want to have a firm for legal practice. Now, the question is, I set like series of questions, and then I told you guys, I asked questions like, do they need to register the business name Taki? Is Taki such that it needs to be registered? That's number one. Number two, in the event of winding up of that particular partnership, would the partners be personally liable for any debt that the partnership incurred? And then number three, I asked if they can sue that the partnership business in itself. That means implying the question of whether or not the partnership business is a legal entity that can sue and, you know, be sued in return. And then thirdly, can you have a partnership agreement, a partnership firm of more than 20 people? So let us say you have about 50. Is it possible under the karma? Those are the questions we are going to be interrogating. But before we move on, let me put it down. So we have four people. We have Taye, we have Kehinde, we have Idowu, and then we have Alaba, and that is T-A-K-I. Taki Legal Practitioners. Do you understand? So I guess the first question that I hope you guys are following my class. If you are following my class, please put it down in the comment section below, so that I would know that you guys are following. Please. So that, because you know that there are times that network will just hang. And then when it hangs, you now start, I'll be teaching you, but none of that you people have disconnected. Do you understand? So at almost every point, I have to be sure that there is a comment going on. So I'll be expecting your comments. Oh, following. Okay, great. Okay, Faith says she's following. Okay, so let us move on. Now, we have four people here that want to form a partnership company. Do you guys understand? And then we then ask the question, that the first thing is, why do you think that these four people want to form a partnership company, as opposed to sole proprietor, like I taught earlier. In the last class, I spoke about sole proprietorship, and I told you that it was a one-man business, you don't need a lot of capital, and all that, and all that. But yeah, when you see that your business is such that you want to invest, you need a lot of capital to invest to take you to the next level, then you might need partnership, because not everybody has money. So for example, if I want to start a bank, I think the requirement for starting a bank is that you must have 25 billion deposited in central bank, so that in the case of winding up of your firm, of that bank, then at least there can be money to pay people that keep an account with you. I'm not too sure, but something like that. So is it possible for somebody like me, like this, or you, to have 25 billionaire? It's possible to have 25 billionaire, but now to just go and keep it in the bank for your business, you now need to start having another money that you used to have branches at different places. Do you want to kill yourself? It's not possible. But it's not like there are certain people that can do it. At least Dangote can do it. Dangote can take money from his pocket to do it. But most times, it is better to have a partnership. Do you guys understand? I am not saying banks are partnership. I am just showing you that when you want to have a big business, when you want to do something massive, most times it is better to have partnership. Running a one-man business is not entirely advisable. Do you guys understand? So when you are talking about the partnership, you are talking about Taye Kehinde Iduwa Alaba and their legal practitioners. They are coming together to form a firm. Now, it is very possible to have a solo-man firm. So you can just have Taye Chambers. Do you understand? That's going to be a sole proprietorship kind of thing. Do you understand? But because they want it to be as big as probably Aluko Anoyebode, if you know Aluko Anoyebode, or as big as, you know, other big firms that we have now, or Simon Cooper's, you know, which is also something like that. So if you want it to be as big, where each partner is going to be drawing resources, that's the essence of a partnership business. Do you understand? So the first question is, would you have to register a partnership business? To answer that question, we first need to outline the different types of partnerships that we have. We have three types of partnership. We have number one, the general partners. Number two, the limited partners. And number three, the limited liability partners. We have three types of partnership. We have the general partners, the limited partners, and the limited liability partners. Do you understand? So when you're saying that, do you need to register a company? When you're talking about general partners, you don't need to register. Sorry, I keep interchanging company for partnership. Please note that the company is different from a partnership. Don't mind me changing company and partnership together. So each time I say company, for the purpose of this class, I actually mean partnership. Except I expressly say that, okay, this one I'm talking about companies. Do you understand? So now, when you're talking about this form of partnership, that's general partnership. General partnership is such that you don't need to register it. Do you understand? That's number one. When you're talking about general partnership, let us say this one is general partnership. When you're talking about general partnership, they have a different legal entity. But before we move into this whole thing, let us first talk about the name, Taki Legal Practitioners. I know that I was trying to answer the question whether or not you need to register the partnership. You don't need to register this partnership if this partnership is a general partnership. Do you understand? You don't need to register the partnership if the partnership is a general partnership. Now, the next question we need to ask is, does this business name need to be registered? Then we have to go to section 846, if I'm correct. No, 814 rather. Section 814, I was interchanging it for section 7. Please, take your camera so that as I read along, you'll be able to follow me. Let me get my camera. Okay, so I've gotten my camera and I hope you are with us too. So if you go to 814 exactly, if you go to section 814, it says that every individual firm or corporation having a place of business in Nigeria and carrying on a business under a general name shall be registered in the manner provided in this section, which means that you shall register the business name, not the business. I told you for general partnership, you don't need to register the business. But you shall register the business name if, in the case of a firm, now, before I proceed, according to Section 2 of the Partnership Law of Lagos State, according to Section 2 of the Partnership Law of Lagos State, it says that a collection of partners is a firm. Do you understand? So when you are reading the comma and you see a place where they write firm as opposed to companies, when you see firm, firm is talking about partnership. Do you understand? Firm is talking about partnership. So every individual firm or corporation, that's why you can see from the section 814, every individual sole proprietorship, firm, partnership, corporation, that is a company. Do you understand? The other types of businesses that we have, incorporated trustee, they are not created for profit. So most times you don't find them all around like in Kama. Do you understand? Now, they are saying that every individual firm of corporation must, true surname, that's of the true surname of all partners, without any addition, if the name does not consist of the true surname of all partners without any addition other than the true forenames of the individual partners or the initials of such forename. Now, according to what you are saying, when you are having, okay, let me read. So there's no need to register the name of incorporated trustees, right? We will get to that. Joel, we will get to that. But for now, let us just stick to partnership. We'll get to incorporated trustees. The next class I'm going to be having would be about this. And I told you that Section 2 of the Partnership Law of Lagos State defines a collection of partners as a firm. Now, they are telling us that where you have only the name of all partners, just the name, where you have only the name of the partners and their surname, that's the true forenames and their surname, then you don't need to register. But when you add any other thing, any other thing that is not their true surname and forename, then you need to register it. Now, if it was TAKI, maybe you would not have been able to write. Do you understand? Like, let us say the name of the firm is just Taki. Do you understand? Our TAKI. But because of the addition of legal practitioners, then you need to register the name. Okay, for those who like watching series a lot, it's like me, I love watching a lot of series. Let us go to a series like Suits. Now, if you watch Suits, especially that watch Suits of 69. Now, when they are putting their names on the wall, that is, you know, if you watch Suits, you understand what I'm talking about. You would see that the names did not include firm or legal practitioners or something. It is just, there was a time it was Spectre Piercing Leads. Do you understand? Or Piercing Spectre Leads. Do you get what I'm talking about? Piercing Spectre Leads, there was even a time it was like up to 8 names on the wall. That name, because there's no addition, do you understand? Because you don't have any addition, then you don't need to register the name. Do you understand? So the registration of a partnership business and the other than the true surnames and forenames or initials of the partners. Do you understand? So that's straightforward. Now, before we move on, now that we have answered the question of you need to register this business name because of the addition of legal practitioners, before we move on, let us talk about how the law governs partnership in Nigeria. Because partnership is in the exclusive list, is it Wall of Fame? Okay. Because partnership is in the exclusive, hello? I think this thing had to reconnect or something like that. Can you hear me? Yeah, network. Can you hear me now? Okay, you can hear me now. Okay, so let us move on. Oh my God, my network. I think my phone overheats when there is no light. So while overheating, it disrupts the network a little bit and so that it can cool back. Do you understand? So, but let us move on since everything is working well now. So as I was saying, because partnership is in the concurrent list. If you know what concurrent list is, if you did constitutional law, then you know that concurrent list is the list meant for the federal government and the state government. That is the list where the federal government and state government can legislate upon. Do you understand? Now, companies is under the the exclusive list. Partnership is under the concurrent list. Do you understand? So because partnership is under the concurrent list, there are three different legislations on partnership in Nigeria. Three. The first one is the Partnership Act of 1890. Partnership Act of 1890 that governs the eastern parts and the northern parts of Nigeria. So we have the Partnership Act of 1890 that governs the eastern part and the northern part of Nigeria. We have the Partnership Law of Western Nigeria, 1959. Partnership Law of Western Nigeria, 1959, that governs Western Nigeria apart from Lagos State. Do you understand? Every other Western state, Ogun, Ondo, Ekiti, and then the rest, they are governed by the Partnership Law of Western Nigeria, 1959. But Lagos State, being, you know, the best state when it comes to making laws, yeah? Now, Lagos State has the Partnership Law of Lagos State, 2003, amended in 2009. Do you understand? We have the Partnership Law of Lagos State, 2003, amended in 2009. So according to Section 3 of the Partnership Law of Lagos State, 2003, amended 2009, it defines a partnership to be two or more people who carry on business for the sole purpose of making profits. Three things has to be in the definition. There has to be two or more people. Do you understand? You cannot have partnership with one person. I wanted to say sole proprietor. Because you are not a sole proprietor, but do you understand? So, if whether or not you're a sole proprietor or a company, you have to go through incorporation. Partnership, you don't have to incorporate your firm. Do you understand? Yeah, but there are times where you have to register it. And that's what I'll be discussing here, but we've not gotten there yet. So, what we are talking about right now is about the definition of partnership according to Section 3 of the Partnership Law of Lagos State, which says that there has to be two or more people. That is the first thing to note about partnership. Number two, there has to be two or more people, that carry on business for the sole purpose of making profit. The next question then becomes, can you have a partnership without a business? Is it possible for there to be a partnership without first having the foundation of a business? There has to be that element of a business for people to form a partnership. And that's the case of Uredi versus Dada. Uredi, I don't know if it is pronounced as Uredisha, but this is it. Uredi versus Dada. Do you understand? In the case of Uredi versus Dada, the court held that you cannot have a partnership without a business. In Section 3 of the Partnership Law of Lagos State, it defines a partnership to be two or more people who carry on business. So that tells you that business is important to form a partnership. So two or more people who carry on business for the sole purpose of making profit. Profit is also very important. What is the point of going into a business without the profit? Do you understand what I'm saying? So we've spoken about partnership, what it is, as name, and I told you that for general partners, you need not register the business. Do you understand? Now let us talk about the numbers. You know, we are talking about three elements of partnership. The first one is that there must be two or more people, as you cannot have a partner with, you can't have partnership with one person, like sole proprietorship or a company under the newcomer. That means there must be two or more people. And then secondly, they must carry on, they are coming together for the sole purpose of the essential feature between partnership and a company. Okay, I'll discuss that towards the end of the video. What is the essential feature between a partnership and a company? I'll discuss it towards the end of the video. But before I continue, this is very important. Please, is there a way I can get this later so I can... Yes, you will be able to get it later. I guess I'll save the video then. Okay, so as I was saying, yes, Joel asked the question as to yes, the difference between partnership and a company. For now, the most important difference is that partnership doesn't have a legal entity. Do you understand? Isn't a legal entity. That means that when you are going to sue the partners, you sue them and collect your money from their pocket. In a company, it is a legal entity, but there are exceptions to that. Do you understand? That's why I said I would differentiate at the end of the video. So let us continue to the two or more people that I was talking about. So under partnership, you have two or more people. Now, can you have 50 people in the partnership? Can you have 100 people? Or what is the maximum number of people that we can have in a partnership? And to answer this question, let us talk about the partnership. Let's go to section 19, please. I hope you have your camera with you. Where is blessing? Blessing that reads karma in class. Come on, read karma. Oh my God. Okay, so what does section 19 say? Section 19 says that no association. You don't have your karma with you, sir. Sorry about that. So section 19 says no association or partnership consisting of more than 20 people shall be formed. That is a money provision. No association or partnership consisting of more than 20 people shall be formed. It tells us automatically that the highest number of people you can have in a partnership is 20. You understand? However, while we look at that, it says no association or partnership consisting of more than 20 people shall be formed. Then go down to the fourth line. Go down to the fourth line. It tells you unless it is registered as a company. So you see, one thing that differentiates a partner, Joel, are you listening now? One thing that differentiates a partnership from a company is that the highest number of people you can get in partnership to form the partnership is 20, but you can get more than 20 in corporations. What's the authority for that? Section 19 sub 1, which says that you cannot have more than 20 people unless it is registered as a company under this act or is formed pursuant to some enactment in force in Nigeria. But now we know what the law says. This law tells us that we need to have 20 people. If you don't, that does not mean that you must have 20 people before you can form a partnership. That's not what. Okay, so can you guys hear me now? Because I think something happened to my network. Again, sorry. Can you guys hear me now? Am I flowing? Hello? Okay, flow. Okay, so let us move on. So now, I was saying that under a partnership, under a partnership, we need to have 20 people as the maximum number of people that you can have in partnership. You can have from 2 to 20, but it cannot exceed 20. According to section 19 sub 1, it says that for you to exceed 20 people, then it must be a company. However, there are certain exceptions to that. Now, in law, there are always exceptions. To be clear, are you saying that partnership people cannot be non-profit organization? No, you can't form a partnership for non-profit organization. According to section 3, my authority is section 3 of the Partnership Law of Lagos State, which says that partnership is formed for business. You'll know that when you are carrying on, please save the video. Okay, you know that when you are having a company formed for business according to the act, a company formed for business carries on its powers as business, while if company formed for charitable purposes or whatever carries on its powers as objects. Do you understand? So here, juxtaposing it to this, the law was very clear when it said business. So what's the full name of the case? Section 19. What law did you cite? Section 19 of CAMA, Companies and Allied Matters Act. Section 19 says that no association shall be formed, no association or partnership consisting of more than 20 persons shall be formed. So if you read this particular this thing, it tells us that no association shall be formed for the purposes of carrying on any business for profit or gain or any individual thereof unless it is registered. Do you understand? So when you're talking about a partnership, when you are having that one for non-business organization, I guess you have to register it as an a company limited by guarantee or as an incorporated trustee. It should not be a partnership, because when you are having a partnership, there are certain things that you are going to be doing when you are having a partnership, and you cannot be doing that for a non-business organization. Do you understand? So it's I don't think it is legally right to say that you can have a non-business organization be called a partnership. The authority is Section 3 of the Partnership Law of Lagos State. So now, I said that you cannot have more than 20 people, Abi. Okay, so let us continue. Since you can't have more than 20 people, I told you that there are certain exceptions to it. Now, our exceptions can be gotten from 2, subsection 2. So what does subsection 2 say? It says that nothing in this section shall applies to cooperative society that has been enacted by that has been registered by another enactment. Do you understand that? So which means where you have a cooperative society in form of a partnership that was registered through another enactment, then you can have more than 20 people. Do you understand? And then the second one says any partnership for the purpose of carrying on legal practice, which means that under I says legal practitioners, while I says as accountants, which means there are 3 types of partnership that can have more than 20 people. The first one is a cooperative society that was formed by an enactment other than this act. The second one is a firm. I told you a firm as defined by Section 2 of partnership law is a firm is a group of partners. Do you understand? So a firm that carries on legal practice. Do you understand? A firm that carries on legal practice can have more than 20 people. And then lastly, a firm that has that carries on accounting business or whatever it is can have more than 20 people. So you can see the exceptions to that rule. I hope you guys are following. Now, what is the legal implication of by any other act is not a legal firm as well, and also it's not a legal firm, it's not a cooperative society, and it's not an accounting firm. What would be the legal implication of that particular firm when it carries on businesses with other people? Now, according to the case of Akilose versus ALT, then I want to get a company law note. I don't know how to pronounce the Yoruba name, so they are quite difficult to pronounce. Am I being? Akilose versus ALT Company Limited. Hope you can see them too. They like doing too much. We lost you for a second. Oh, I'm very sorry. Okay, a partnership of over 100 members, 100, they don't even count down, not 20, 30, 100 people of the Ondo District Timber Group, was held by the court to be an association that is null and void, which means that the legal effect is that it's null and void. Don't forget that the wordings of the KAMA is that no association shall be formed, which means that when you form it, you are going against a mandatory provision. It says no association shall be formed, and then you are going against Akilose versus ALT Company Limited. You are going against mandatory provision, which is null and void, and that's the case of Akilose versus ALT Company Limited. So, now moving on, I hope you guys we are getting somewhere when it comes to partnership. Now, we've spoken about the general partners. Why not we talk about we are still on general partners. So one very important thing about the general partnership is that you don't have any separate legal entity, which means that where the company incurs liability or any debts, all the partners, if Taki legal practitioners were involved in a 50 million naira, whatever it is, and then Taki does not have the money, as you know that they don't have a legal person. Do you understand? For example, you know that a company, let us say Turkey Legal Practitioners was a company. A company can buy a house. Do you understand? It can buy a house in the company's name, not a partner's name, in the company's name. But because Turkey Legal Practitioners is not a registered business, So, because Turkey Legal Practitioners is not a registered business, it doesn't have a legal entity, Turkey Legal Practitioner cannot go and buy property. The partners are the ones that buy properties in their name, but they can just dedicate that property for Turkey Legal Practitioners. Let us say the head office of Turkey Legal Practitioners. But the person that is the owner of that building is not Turkey, but you know, the partners themselves. They can buy it together, or one person can own it, and then they all know that, although it's in your name, we are all the owners of this thing. Do you understand? So in the case of Solomon versus Solomon, I'm sorry for bringing Solomon into this, but just imagine Solomon as a person, you know, the company's name is Solomon, Abi. Now, Solomon company, in quotes, can go and buy property. Do you understand? Solomon company can go and buy property, and Solomon is not the owner of that property. I'm just giving you an example. So, Taye, if this was a company, Taye can buy a property. Let us say this is a company, like expressly, this is a real company. Taye can buy property for himself if he chooses to, but where if Taye... But if this company buys a property, then it is none of Taye's property, it is none of Kehinde's property, Idowu's property, Alaba's property, it is the company's property. But when it comes to partnership, a partnership cannot buy, like this, Taki Legal Practitioners cannot buy it because the law does not even recognize it as a person. When you are talking about a legal entity, the record recognizes that thing as a person. Do you understand? So here, they don't recognize this as a person. So when you buy it in this. So if there is any debt, let us say Turkey Legal Practitioners incurred 50 million naira in debt, or they have to collect the money from all of these people like this. So there is no anything to block or shield. They are all personally liable for any debt and liability that the company incurs. They are personally liable for every debt and liability that the company incurs. I hope you guys understand that. Now, also related to general partnership, now note that this rule applies, most of the rules that I'm saying here, they all apply to other forms of partnership as well. For example, you cannot have more than 20 people. Applies to general partners, limited partners, and limited liability partners. Do you understand? What else? This next rule that I want to say, company isn't a separate legal entity. First of all, a company incorporated according to the act is a separate legal entity. But this one, it is not a company. This one is a partnership. A partnership is not a separate legal entity. Okay, association, yes. Let us not call it an association. Let us call it a partnership. A partnership, a general partnership, is not a separate legal entity, not a company. You understand? A company incorporated under the act, duly incorporated, is a separate legal entity. But a partnership is not, a general partnership is not a separate legal entity. So now let me continue. When you are talking about the partnership now, every partner is an agent of the firm as well as agent of every other partner. Do you understand? Because every partner has actual and apparent authority. I'm very sure you did CT, so you know what apparent authority is, what actual authority is, and an ostensible authority. So according to section 6 of the property, according to section 6 of the Partnership Law of Lagos State, every partner is an agent of the firm and also an agent of other partners. Do you understand? Now, the consequence of this is that the partner will bind, the firm and third parties whenever there is a contract made. So even if they did not have to sit down with all the partners and one person, made a contract with another person by virtue of the fact, okay, so in law firms we have partners. Can it be classified under partnership? Yes. Now, yes, law firms, except they are corporated, which I don't even think they are most times partnerships. Do you understand? I don't think law firms are corporated. Most of them are partnership. Do you understand? So what I'm saying is that Taye, for example, made a contract with one particular firm. Whatever contract Taye makes with that particular firm is binding on other partners as well as the firm. Do you understand? So where a partner carries out a business, okay, yeah, where a partner carries out a business with some other people, then it is binding on that partner as well as other partners and the firm as a whole. That's section 6. Now, where that partner is devoid of that particular authority to do that thing, let us say they've restricted this partner from doing this particular authority, then if the third party does not have notice of that, of the fact that he's devoid of that authority, it is still binding on others. Do you understand? Naturally, every partners have equal authority. So which means a partner can, you know, go and make business with other people. But where probably they've orally, you are going to have a partnership deed or by conduct. Do you understand? So you can have a partnership, you can start a partnership orally. Yeah, hey, my guy, Alpha now, or my get this kind of business. Alpha, okay, we'll put money together now. Bam. Do you understand? So you can have a partnership by that. You can also have a partnership by, writing it down in a partnership deed where all the terms of the partnership is outlined and the responsibilities, the duty of every partner is outlined. You can do that. And also, partnership can be done by conduct. Do you understand? So if we did not expressly say that we are going into a partnership, we don't have the name of a firm, but two of us are contributing money for something to do it together, what else is a partnership if not that? Do you understand? So let us say there is this container of oil that I want to ship from Nigeria to America, and then with the whole processing and everything, I would need 100 million to get 500 million naira in profit. And then I just went to meet my guy Abed now, Alpha, come help me contribute. We did not say anything about partnership, but I just tell him, please, and all that. And then he said, okay, I will transfer the money. But when the profit comes, I'm getting 50%. We didn't say it about partner. He just gave me money. Do you understand? And then I used it for it. And then with the intention that when the business comes, when the money comes, that's the profit, I'm going to give him back his share. Let us go back to definition of partnership according to section 3. It says when there are two or more people for the sole purpose of carrying business. Here we have two people for the sole purpose of carrying tanker. I mean, fuel from Nigeria to America. Back and to share, it can be formed by conduct. Do you understand? So you can have oral partnership written, and partnership by conduct. So you are having, when you have a written agreement, for example, and then Taye does not have the power under that written agreement to bind them in a contract. If that third person that Taye is dealing with doesn't know that Taye does not have that power, it is still binding on them. That's section 7 and section 9 of the section 7 and section 9 of the partnership law of Lagos State, which says that a partner barren of authority can still bind the partners where a third party with whom he transacts is an agent, which means you can bind people in transactions and all that. But where a partner is devoid of that power to bind people, then the third party, if the third party knows, then nothing is wrong. You cannot put the liability on them. But if the third party does not know, then he is still an agent of the, so whatever right comes from that particular transaction or whatever liability comes from it, you know, is spread to every other partner as well as this thing. So I hope you people understand what I've been teaching so far. I really want to round this up, section partnership law of Lagos State. Section 7 and section 9 tells us that partner, when devoid of authority, can still bind other partners. Now let us go to limited partnership. What does limited partnership mean? A limited partner, there was a problem with general partners because people started getting scared of contributing money. I understand. Okay. Now, people started getting scared of contributing money into partnership. Because you know that partnership can be created by conduct. It need not be in writing. It need not be which means you can talk. So now, okay, I have this group of friends. They are running one kind of deal, and then they need money. That's it. The deal that they are running has to do with coding sites and all that. So they contribute money, try to code a site and all that and all that. And then I was like, oh, with the way the prospect of the business sounded in my ear, it sounded like something I want to invest in, but I don't want to be part of it. You understand? I just want to give you my money, and then wait till the end of the month or of the year. Let us say I'm giving you March, then I wait till December. And then I just want to cash out. With the way the prospect sounded, it sounded like at the end of the year, that's in December, I can get like 1.5. That's a good investment to me, but I don't want to be part of them. But if I give them the money to do business, are you listening? And then, if I give them the money to do business, and then I, you know, wait for the returns of the money, it then means that there is a partnership by conduct. Do you understand? So therefore, because there is a partnership by conduct, anything that happens to that business, they can come and chase the money down into my account. You know that I've already given them the 1 million naira. Now they can come and chase. If let's say those ones went to go and incur 50 million naira debts, they cannot come and chase money into my account to be able to offset their debts. Do you understand? So that became a problem for general partners and people trying to invest. Do you understand? So they now created a concept called limited partnership. Do you understand? Now, limited partnership is still the same thing as general partner, which means that you don't need to register you need to register a limited partner rather. What I wanted to say is that you don't need to a limited partner does not have a legal entity. Yes, that's what I wanted to say. So a limited partner doesn't have a legal entity. So general partner, no legal entity. Limited partner, no legal entity. Which means that here, let us say we have these people. Alaba here, he doesn't want to leave. Do you understand? Alaba here, let us say this one contributed 10 million. Alaba said, oh, let me just give you people 20 million. But when the profit comes, I get 50% of the share. Why you people get whatever it is? Do you understand? So because he's putting more, he's saying that he's getting 50% of the share. But he does not want to be part of the company. On a normal day, when you are putting money into business to get profit, you are forming a partnership automatically. But he said, I don't want to be a general partner. Because if you people fuck up, I will not be here. I'm not part of the management of this company, of this firm rather. I just want to invest my money and, you know, leave. Do you understand? Now, when you are talking about limited partnership, you can close Alaba with something called limited partnership. Note that in limited partnership, the other partners are general partners, except from those people that say, I don't want to be part of this firm's management. Do you understand? The only those people that say, I don't want to be part of these people's management, those are the only ones that are limited partners. And for limited partners, you don't come and chase the money into their pocket. It means that, as the word implies, limited, it means that every debt and liability is limited to the amount that they have contributed to the firm. Every debt and liability is limited. So here, if this one, they still have 50 billion naira in debt, or let us say they, for the sole purpose of this example, they had 100 million naira in debt. The only money that this one is liable for is 20 million naira. You cannot come and sell his house and say that you are part of partnership. He's not part of the general partnership of the firm. He's only a limited partner. Do you people business and then say, I am not, you know, part of this business. And say, I'm not part of this business. I just want to drop money and then get my share later. Do you guys understand? So, for that, we can look at the fact that A limited partnership must be registered. So yes, as I was saying, a limited partnership must be registered with the Registry of Limited. Can you guys hear me? Please put it down in the comment section so I know before I continue. Hello. Okay, can you hear me? Thank you very much. So as I was saying, when you are talking about limited partnership, if a limited partnership is not registered, oh, I'm sorry, it's breaking, it's my network, or my phone is overheating, I guess that's the reason. I'm very sorry. So when a limited partnership is not registered, yes, but network is bugging some of us. Sorry about that. Okay, so when a limited partnership is not registered, what then becomes the problem? The problem is that, or its implication is that, that limited partner Alaba here, if he doesn't go and register it with the Registry of Limited Partnership, then it automatically becomes a general partnership, because a general partnership need not be registered. So for a limited partnership, you have to go and put your water at the back. It works. Oh, are you serious? Can you hear me? Okay, so let's continue then. Okay, let's continue then. So, as I was saying, you have the limited partner. I want to believe that you guys can hear what I'm saying, Abi. Okay, so you have the limited partner, and I told you that if you don't register the limited partner with the Registry of Limited Partnership, by virtue of that, the limited partner automatically becomes a general partner. For general partnership, they need not be registered. For limited partnership, you have to register it, especially this one. You have to register that you are part of this partnership, but my own, I am limited. They can do whatever they want to do. I am limited. That's number one. That is one time where a limited partner becomes, if a limited partner is not registered, then it becomes a general partner. Another time that a limited partner can become a general partner, even after registration, is when a limited partner meddles with the affairs of the firm. A limited partner is not supposed to be in the management of the firm. Like the example or the scenario that I painted earlier, I told you that when you are talking about limited partnership, can you hear me? Can you guys hear me? Hello? Okay, good. I told you that when we are talking about limited partnership, the person just wants to put the money in the firm and leave. Do you understand? He's not into the business. When a limited partner, even though registered, decides to meddle with the affairs of the business, enters into the management of the business, then that limited partner is automatically, a general partner, whether or not he has been registered. Do you guys understand? So it means that as a limited partner, don't act into put your money, come back and collect your share. That is what it is. That's what limited partnership is. Now, when you are talking about general partnership, when you want to leave a general partnership, when you want to stop a general partnership, there are 5 ways of stopping a general partnership, which I want to distinguish between a limited partnership and a general partnership. So let us start with the first way you can end a general partnership. Number one, by express agreement between the parties. All the parties can come together and say, hey, I'm done, I'm tired, okay, let us end the agreement. It has been a long journey, it was fun while it lasts, but right now, let us end the agreement. Bam. By express agreement between the parties. So Taye, Kende, Idiwa, and Alaba can all come together over dinner or through a cocktail party to end the agreement and say, this is the end of our partnership agreement. That's number one. Number two, if entered for a fixed term at the expression of that fixed term. Now imagine the three of them say, okay, we just want this thing to be 5 years. Now at the expression of 5 years, automatically it ends. But they can renew it either by their conduct, by acting as if it did not end. It means that automatically it has been renewed. This partnership is going to end in 5 years, 2 years, 3 years, 1 year. Then at the end of such term, it automatically ends. But it can continue. So if the partnership was supposed to end on the 31st of March, and then they still continued dealing as partners after 31st, it automatically continues like that. Do you understand? It is not until... Because you can't say that the partnership ends automatically on that day, and so everything that they've been doing after that is no longer a partnership. No, it will only... no longer be partnership when they don't act together as partners anymore. You know, partnership can be created by conduct. Now, that is the second one. The third one, if entered for a single venture. So I told you about the fuel that I want to ship from Lagos to America. Now, can you guys hear me? Because my screen, it keeps writing reconnecting. So I just want to know if you guys are following so that I don't talk and then you say I did not hear anything. Please, can you hear me? Oh, okay, good. Okay, so as I was saying, so in that ship that I said the this thing I said I was going to transfer from Lagos to from Lagos to America. Do you understand? To get money. Now, at the expiration of that time with the person that I want to do it with, let us say I and Awe, Timileyin Awe, just little break in transmission. Oh, I'm very sorry for that. So I and Timileyin Awe now. It was the person that came to me that I told Timileyin, please, I just want to transfer this thing from here to America. And then, you know, at the expiration of transferring it and getting the profit out of it, our partnership ends. So the first one is express agreement. The second one is at the expiration of the term, the term, if there is any fixed term. The third one is at the termination of a particular venture that we go into, you know. So at the termination of that venture, then our partnership automatically stands terminated. Now the fourth one is when a partner gives notice to the other partner. That is, if it is entered into for an undefined term, when a partner gives notice to the other partner. So what do I mean by an undefined term? Where we didn't necessarily put a fixed time. No, like this one, they said 5 years. We didn't put a fixed time. It wasn't for a particular venture. We actually wanted to do this for a long deal. So for the past 10 years, we have been partners. But at some point, I think I want to travel out and go to Lithuania, for example, Santorini, yes. I want to go to Santorini and spend the rest of my life. I am tired of this Nigeria. The trouble is too much. I can just come to meet you and write in notice. Now, I can send a notice to you and tell you either on the date of the notice, that the date that the notice is getting to you, or any date specified in the notice. So if I specify that, okay, this agreement should end on the 1st of August, then on that 1st of August it ends. Or this agreement should end when you see it. You understand? The moment you get to see it, it ends. So whatever date that you know you put there, the agreement is totally called off. You understand? I think that's section 33 sub 1 and 2 of the property law of Lagos State. Of the partnership law of Lagos State. It tells us that you can end a partnership by notice. And then the fifth one is that any partnership as at the point where it becomes unlawful, that the business that is being carried out becomes unlawful, it stands dissolved. So if it was from the beginning that you have been carrying out, you know, in a general partnership, you don't need to register it. All you just need to do is carry on business. So if the business you people came together and invested money into was to be buying and selling cocaine, which is an unlawful business, then from the moment when you people started the business no even day for law at all. They don't even recognize them. So any partnership, or let's say you guys wanted to be exporting and importing actual lawful goods, but at some point you start meddling in unlawful dealings, then at that point, a partnership stands dissolved. So those are the five ways a partnership can be dissolved. Express agreement is number one. A notice is number two. A fixed term, expiration of that fixed term, number three. A particular venture, at the termination of that particular venture, number four. Then, when you deal in unlawful things. Why did I go into the ways we can end partnership? Because I wanted to distinguish it from limited partnership. Now, when you are talking about limited partnership, limited partners yes, now, I told you that there are five things. Now, five things, I already said them. I told you that number one, express agreement. Number two, termination. Termination of a particular time, like when you enter into a venture, when you are done with that particular venture, then it's terminated. Do you understand? Number three, at the end of a particular time. Oh, are you serious? Okay. Number three, at the end of a particular time. Number four, and then nice to meet you. Nice to see you here, Ima Pedro. That's really nice to see you here. Express agreement and then the rest. So I hope you guys have gotten it. Please, I want to move on. Now, you know, I said that a partnership agreement. Now, for both the legal partnership and the limited partnership, they do not have legal entity. They are not a separate legal entity. That's the case of Smith versus Anson. Smith versus Anson. Let me spell it on the board. Hey, why did I drop my marker? Oops. Smith versus Anson. So in the case of Smith versus Anson, the court held that the partnership is devoid of legal entity. A partnership does not have legal entity. So as I was saying, when you are juxtaposing general partnership with limited partnership, all these ones are liable. The general partners in the limited partnership are liable to the debt of the company, but the limited partner is not. The limited partner only stands liable when he does not register his limited partnership and when he meddles into the affairs of the company. Another example or another difference is that a limited partner cannot end a partnership by notice. A general partner can end a partnership by notice. That's the fourth difference. The fourth difference of a general partner, which can be seen in section 33, sub 1 and 2 of the partnership law of Lagos State, partnership by notice. But a limited partner cannot end a partnership. Do you understand? A limited partner cannot end a partnership. That's by notice. So, I think I'm done with limited partnership. So let us go to the next kind of partnership that we have, and that's the limited liability partnership. Are you guys here? Or this now is connected again? Okay, you are here. Okay. So, following. Okay, good. So when you're talking about a limited liability partner, what does that mean? Yeah, thank you very much, Judith. Thank you, love. Okay, so when you're talking about a limited liability partner, what does that mean? A limited liability partnership It's all good now. Okay, good. A limited liability partnership means that the all of them like this, they don't, I think for me to explain limited liability partnership, let me explain it using the comma. Do you understand? But the before this comma 2020, it was only Lagos that operated limited liability. Before comma 2020, only Lagos operated limited liability. Every other state, they operated only general partnership and limited partnership. It was until comma 2020. So in comma 1990, there was no limited liability. So that is one of the new innovations of this new comma. Do you understand? You know, when it comes to company, now you don't need to register your articles and all those. When it comes to partnership, one of the new innovations of the comma is that you don't need to register a partnership agreement. Sorry, is that you don't need to register partnership, is that you now have a limited liability. Sorry about that. Okay, good. Is that you now have a limited liability. And let us go to section 746 of the comma. 746. What is in 746? Are you guys there? If you are there, say yes, I am there. Section 746. My network went bad during the limited liability. I only had four. Continue watching, you would see it. I think I re-explained it. Yes, we are. Okay. So section 746 tells us that a limited liability partner, a limited liability partnership is a body corporate formed and incorporated under this act and is a legal entity separate from the partners. There are two things. Now, it introduces to us for the first time a limited liability. And then it tells us that it is a body corporate, which means it is a legal entity. That when you read on, a body corporate formed and incorporated under this act and is a separate separate legal entity from the partner. So let us understand what section 4 says. It tells us that a limited liability partnership is just like a company. Do you understand? Now, when you're talking about a limited liability partnership, they have to be registered. A general partnership need not be registered. In a limited partnership, a limited partner has to be registered with the registered trustee. The trustee of limited liability. Now, if a limited partner does not register, then he automatically is a general partner. But when you want to operate a limited liability partnership, where or anything that happens to Turkey legal practitioners does not affect them. That's what it means. It means if Turkey legal practitioners get a debt of 1 billion naira, it is the Turkey legal practitioners that get the 1 billion naira. It does not extend to these people. Do you understand? Unlike in a general partnership, then it extends. In a limited partnership, it extends except Alaba. But in a limited liability partnership, it does not extend at all. Do you understand? Now, so it tells us that it's a body corporate that has a different this thing. Now, subsection 2 tells us that a limited liability partner shall have perpetual succession. That is to tell you that in general partnership, it ends after death. Do you understand? In general partnership, the moment one of the partner dies or something like that, the whole partnership agreement is dissolved. So which means it's also part of a way to end partnership. That means we now have 6 ways to end a partnership. Do you understand? 6 ways to end a partnership. Now, limited liability has perpetual succession, which means that if anything happens to the partner, it continues. But here, the moment one of the partner dies, except there is another express agreement to continue it, it stands dissolved. Do you understand? So if Tayeka and Idowu Alaba have a general partnership, Idowu dies, this partnership is dissolved. That Turkey is dissolved, except they now want to, they come back and agree or by their conduct they continue it. That is when you have turkey continue. But for this one, limited liability partnership, any change in the of a limited liability partnership does not affect the rights, the liability of the limited partnership. It means that what turkey is different from this. Therefore, any rights accrued or obligation accrued, whether or not these ones change, does not affect this one. You know, in a general partner, there is no this one. We just have a name. So whatever they do, if one partner goes, everything is scattered. I told you, this means it's dissolved. You don't have to restart it again from the beginning. Once the partner says, ah, mi o se mo, o ti su mi, I am tired, I want to leave. Boom, everything ends. Do you understand? Unless they say that, you know, they want to restart everything again. That's when all those partner, but the partner that left, restarted another partnership. You guys understand? So, here, whether or not one leave, one says, this one, it continues. It does not affect the rights, it does not affect anything, it continues. It goes on like that. So that is that for limited partnership. I'm trying to be very, very, very fast. So I hope you guys totally understand this. I want to draw to the close to the end of the class because it's already 70 minutes and that's 1 hour 10 minutes. Does anybody have any question before I move on? Does anybody have any question? I'm currently waiting for questions before I do a rundown of the class again, and then I hope you guys can hear me. I want to do a rundown of the class and round it up. So before I do a rundown around the top, does anybody have any questions so far? Mabino, I don't understand. What happened? What happens where a limited partner? What happened where a limited partner dies in a limited partnership? Okay, so the question is, what happens when a limited partner dies in a limited partnership? If a limited partner dies in a limited partnership, it does not affect the company. We have to, this. These are three people. I hope you guys can see the board. If you can't see, let me bend. I hope you can see it now. So we have three people here. These are the people in charge of a limited partnership. The moment a limited partnership is formed, this person, who is called Turkey legal practitioner, is now recognized as a separate entity apart from this ones. So if this one, like, you know that for this one to operate, these ones have to collectively agree. It's just like a company. Because this one cannot operate without the agreement of this one. That's the essence. So if this one like he dies, one he said is no longer doing, it does not affect the fact that this one still stands, and every right that accrued while this one, like, let's say, can you guys hear me? Can you all hear me? Please, can you all hear me? Okay, you can. Okay. So the only difference between LLP under KAMA and a company is the limitation. Thank God, you finally brought the light. So I guess my phone will stop overheating. Okay, so that's correct. One of the major differences between a company and a limited liability between a company and a limited liability partnership is as to the numbers. One of the very important differences. I can't say it's the only difference yet until we have properly examined partnership and properly examined companies. Do you understand? But a foreseeable difference right now, which is very glaring, is the fact that a limited liability company is different from, a limited liability company has 20 people as the highest, except it's a legal limited liability. So according to your, hello Judith, can you hear me? So according to your deduction, your logical deduction, it means that when you have a partnership, yes, you see, it's just beginning to get into my head now, and I hope you guys can hear me. Can you hear me? Can you guys hear me? Okay, so Judith, I think it's Judith that asked that question. Judith asks if the only difference is that is the partner. That cannot be said to be the only difference. I just thought of it now. And the reason is because before you can have a company, you must have a memorandum and articles. If your articles are designed in such a way that they are not in line with the articles given by the CAMA. You know that according to Section 32, it tells us that there are certain types of companies that need not register their articles. Then you now have to look at Section 34 that tells us that limited liability companies need not register their article when the article is the same thing as that one in the CAMA. And those ones who did not change anything. Do you understand? Now, but that's not what we are talking about now. What we are talking about is the difference between partnership and a company. So apart from the fact that you need 20 people, you know, by your deduction, it means that a law firm who can have about 50 to 100 people or thereabouts is the same thing as a company. But you cannot say that because you don't need to register documents for a limited liability company. I don't think there is a procedure that says that you must register the partnership deed. I don't think there's a procedure. They might necessarily be, but I don't think so. Unlike the companies where you must register the partnership. Sorry, where you must register the memorandum. So I don't think you need to register the partnership deed, but we can all look that up and determine whether or not you need to. You understand? So yes, and it's too early to say that that's the only difference, Judith. Can you all hear me before I move on? I think somebody asked a question after that. Taye, I actually don't really understand. A limited liability company, in a limited liability company, are you saying that the partners is a separate legal entity from the partnership and does not make it a company? It is not a company. It is a limited liability company, a limited liability partnership that has a separate legal entity from the partners. That does not necessarily make that a company, because for you to have company of incorporation, there are so many things that must be put in place. But for you to have partnership, especially a limited liability partnership. Okay, I hope you guys can hear me now. For you to have a limited liability partnership, you don't have to go through the rigorous procedures that you follow on a normal day if you were incorporating a company. Do you understand? You don't have to follow the rigorous procedures that you would follow on a normal day if you were to incorporate a company. So, is there any other question before I round up and end the class? Is there any other question? Okay, so in the absence of any other question, let me just round up. So we started this class and then we were trying to tell ourselves what limited partnership is. So in a limited partnership, you must have three people, important things. According to the section 3 of the partnership law of Lagos State, there must be three important things. Number one, there must be more than two people. Now, when we looked at section 19. When we looked at section 19, it tells us that you cannot have more than 20 people except you are operating a legal firm or you are operating a accounting firm or it is a cooperative society formed by any other enactment. Where it doesn't fall into any of those three categories, then you cannot have more than 20 people as an association. That was where we started in the beginning. And then from there, that when we are looking at the definition of partnership according to section 3, it tells us that there must be two to 20 people, and then they must carry out a business. If they are not carrying out a business, it cannot be a partnership. Already versus Dada. And then lastly, you must they carry out the business for the sole purpose of making profit. Section 2 of the property law of Lagos State tells us that a firm is a collection of partners. Do you understand? And then when you're talking about general partnership, you don't need to register the business. You only have to register the business name when the business name is not the true forenames and surnames of the partners. And that is section 814. That's 814 subsection 1. That says that you don't need to register except it's not the true forenames and the true surnames. And then after that, we moved into the fact that if a partner is more than 20 people, then it stands null and void. And that's the case of Achilose versus ALT, where we had 100 members of the Ondo Timber District Group, who have about 100 members. The court held that such partnership is null and void. And also we have the case of Smith versus Hansen. In the case of Smith versus Hansen, the court held that a partner, especially a general partner, does not have a separate legal entity. Do you understand? Which means that the partners are personally liable for every debt that has been incurred while the partners were carrying on business. Do you guys understand? And then after that, what did we talk about? I mean, it's trying to round up and see if I can clear everything up now. And then after that, we spoke about agent, and we said that every partner is an agent of the other partners as well as the firm. So when you're talking about partnership, you are saying that a partner is an agent of the other partner, section 6 of the partnership law of Lagos State. And where a partner is devoid of such authority and the other party, that the third party, doesn't know that that partner is devoid of such authority, then that the partners are still going to be held liable. Do you understand? For such debt or whatever that has been accrued. And that's section 7 and section 9 of the partnership law of Lagos State. What else? And then we spoke about how to start a partnership. The partnership can be started either by oral agreement, by express agreement that is written, or by conduct. And how can you end a partnership? Either of six ways. I said five earlier, but at the end of it, I added debt. So what is the first one? The first one is by express agreement to end it. Where the partner says, we want this to end. The second one is where they entered it for a particular venture at the termination of that venture. Does the 20 person maximum he applies to LLP as well, because the wordings of that section says no association or partnership shall be formed and it shall be more than 20 people. So if it says that, it means that it applies. Do you understand? And it created three exceptions. In the three exceptions, limited liability partnership is not there. So by virtue of that, let us move on. So this 6 ways by which partnership can be ended. First one, express agreement. Second one, at the termination of the venture that they entered into. The third one, at the expiration of, when it's for a fixed term, at the expiration of such fixed term. The fourth one, when it is not for a fixed term, then a notice given by the partner. And note that that notice, when related to a limited partner cannot terminate a partnership by notice. Only a general partner. Do you understand? And then the last one, where they start an unlawful business. Then the last one, where there is debt of either of the partners. Note that debt does not affect a limited liability partner. Whether or not the partner dies, the partnership continues. So, after that, what did we speak about? After that, we spoke about limited partnership. And then I told you that for you to have a limited partner, it means that that particular partnership must be registered with the Registry of Limited Partnership. Where it is not registered, it stands to be a general partnership. Do you understand? Where it is not registered, it stands to be a general partnership. That's number one. Then number two, when he meddles in the affairs of the business, then he becomes a general partner. If he meddles in the affairs of the business, he becomes a general partner by such extension. And the limited partner does not incur liability that the firm incurs. If the firm incurs any liability, the limited partner doesn't incur such liability, except he has done any of the two aforementioned things. And then, I think after that, that was the end of that. And then after that, we moved into the limited partnership, limited liability partnership. And in the limited liability partnership, I spoke about the fact that it must be registered. And also, I spoke about the fact that prior to 2020, it's only Lagos that operated that. That's the limited liability partnership. No other state operated it. And I told you, when you are related to partnership, the partnership is governed by three acts. What are those three acts? The partnership law of Lagos State that governs Lagos State, the Partnership Act of 1890 that governs Eastern and Northern Nigeria, and then the partnership law of Western Nigeria that governs, that's 1959, that governs Western Nigeria but Lagos State. Do you guys understand? So those are the three acts that govern partnership. And I told you that partnership is in the concurrent list and not in the exclusive list. That is the reason you have companies are in the exclusive list. That's why the reason you have only CAMA regulating companies in the whole of Nigeria. There's no other legislation made by any state that is regulating companies directly. Do you understand? And then you have partnership. And I told you partnership is in the concurrent list. That's why you have limited liability partnership in CAMA, because federal government can also legislate in states anything listed in the concurrent list. Do you guys understand? So for limited liability partnership, the first time we had it for the whole of Nigeria was according to the 2020 Act. Do you understand that? Yes, limited liability partnership must be registered in accordance with the Act. A limited liability partnership as a separate legal entity, according to Section 2 of Section 746, a limited liability partnership also has perpetual succession. Hey, Lord God. Okay, so after that, what else? Limited liability partnership. I think that's the end. I hope you guys understood. Please, I'm about to end the class. If you understand, please just write "I understand." Every single person that is currently watching, just write "I understand" so that I'll know that yes, this is done. And if you have a question, please put your question. I'm about to end the class right now. If you understand, just write "I understand." Thank you. Please, I'm expecting that. Please, if you understand, just write "I understand." Oh, thank you very much, Amanda Abo. Thank you very much, Bola Rewa Akorede. Thank you very much, Amanda. said things. Who else? Balariwa, thank you. Judith, I understand, thank you. So, nobody has a question? I understood, this was helpful, thank you. Love, Maintainer. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you so much. Okay, no problem. So guys, I want us to solve past questions on this. So I'll send the past question in the evening. I hope I'll be available. I'll send the past question in the evening, and then we are going to discuss it on Sensei app. The reason I want us to discuss is so that we can imbibe the whole thing into us, and you know, because we are trying to prepare for exams, right? So I'll send past questions or a problem question relating to it, and then we can solve it together on Sensei app. Please, I implore every one of us to get the past question, or don't worry, I'll send it to you via the message, and you just download the Sensei app. Please go to Apple Store. Sorry, it is not on Apple Store. I'm very sorry. It is only on Play Store. So if you are using Android, please go to Play Store and download the app, so that when I send it to you, you can solve it and we can share our information. When someone writes a problem question, answers a problem question, you can see the method by which the person answered it, and you can see how the person cited cases and sections. It's going to help you when you are reading, or how to answer those questions when we see them in exam. So this is a community learning, like I said earlier. We have to help one another. So I would really appreciate if we all turn out for this and help one another. So thank you very much. My next class is going to be on Saturday, and on Saturday I'll be talking about evidence. And then my next class after that, evidence, I'll be talking about fact and issue and relevancy and admissibility. Then after that, on Sunday, I'll be talking about incorporated trustees, and in relation to partnership, I might be talking about the case of Force versus Abotu, or I'll be talking about incorporated trustees and incorporation, so that we can move as fast as possible, because I want us to, after we are done with this, I want us to go into the mandatory provisions, the enabling provisions and all that, the new innovations in relation to that in the CAMA. They talk about the memorandum and the articles of association, how to author the memorandum, how to author the articles, the entrenched provisions. Then after that, we have a lot of things to talk about. So I hope to see you guys as soon on Saturday. Thank you so much for sticking around, and thank you so much for learning. I'll see you guys next time. God bless you. Have a wonderful day.